Hey, welcome back. It's Professor Hendricks, and today I'd like to talk to you about how to process a FASTQ file using the Biopython SeqIO module. Now, I have a FASTQ file right here in front of me. If you saw my last video on FASTQ files and how they're defined, you would see that this is a FASTQ file. And if you haven't seen that video, check it out. But basically, this is a FASTQ file. It happens to be ChIP-seq data for a Drosophila heat shock factor. So encoded in this information are essentially could be processed along with a control file of just regular DNA or mock IP or something. You could use this to identify peaks in the genome where the heat shock factor binds. And then ultimately, you could do motif finding to figure out what that motif, that binding site, that transcription factor binding site looks like under those peaks. But today, I just want to show you how to process a FASTQ file. Now, you wouldn't necessarily want to do what I'm about to do today. You might want to use a pre-existing tool like Skewer or FASTQ Trimmer. There's a lot of options for trimming quality scores, but I wanted to show you how you might go about reading this with BioPython. First thing we want to do is we want to define a script. So I'm just going to define a script with Emacs here, and I'm just going to call it process FASTQ. And this is just an example. I'll just show you how to basically loop through the FASTQ file and extract information. So first thing we want to do is we want to import some modules. So definitely we want to import SeqIO, which is from bio import SeqIO. I'm going to go ahead and import sys too, because I want to, if I can type it, because I want to I want to have some sort of interface. So let's just start with the interface. So I might define a usage statement, and what I would do is I would say usage, and then I would say the script name itself, which is stored in sys.argv of 0. That's the first argument on the command line. And then I might remind myself, hey, this is expecting a FASTQ file as the second argument. And so if there are two arguments in sys.argv, which is a list that's extracted by the sys module, then I'm okay. If not, then I don't have enough arguments, so I need to do something like this. If sys.argv, the len in sys.argv is not equal to 2, I want to print the usage statement, and I want to exit. And otherwise, then I have my FASTQ file defined as sys.argv of 1. Now, if you were going to be a little more sophisticated, you might do some sort of check to make sure that it was a properly formatted FASTQ file and stuff like that. But I'm just going to assume that it is for now, and I want to try to loop through the different records. So what I might do is I might say something like the following. I might do for record in seqio.parse. And seqio.parse takes in two arguments. It takes in a file name, in this case it's my FASTQ file, and it takes in a file format, in this case is going to be FASTQ. And so that is the beginning of a for loop. So I want to remind you that I have the for here. I end with a colon, and then in Python I have to indent all the lines that are going to be processed for each record in that FASTQ file. I need to indent under this for loop. So now I might do something. So how about this? I'll just say, I want to show you an example record. And what I want to do is do record, just it's equal to record, and then break. So what this is going to do is it's going to enable me to just print the record and see what it looks like. Maybe it'll be something useful, maybe it won't. But the break will basically exit the first time that's encountered, and it will exit the innermost for loop, in this case, the only for loop. So let's see what happens. So if I do Python process FASTQ, I get my usage statement, and then I can type in reads.fastq, and then it prints the information. So I can see there's a lot of information, a lot of lines that have been extracted, including a seq object, a BioPython seq object. Now, if you haven't seen my video on BioPython seq objects, please do. I'll put a link in the description. And you also have the FRED quality. So this is already parsed that out for us. Now, how we actually get that FRED quality is a little bit, I actually have to review that myself. But basically, it's able to extract the ID. So it's extracted the read ID, and it's extracted the description, which is the full length definition line here. That is the entire line that followed the at symbol. So now I want to go back to my script and see if I can do something more interesting with this. So what I'd like to do today is I would like to just go ahead and process this in such a way that I'll plot the average quality score as a function of position in the reads. Now, again, you wouldn't want to necessarily want to do that in practice, but it's just an example that would illustrate how you might go about doing something like that. So say you wanted to write your own quality trimmer. And let me do something. I'm going to print the record the length of the record.seq. And this is just a way to do this. And actually, I'm going to copy that out and put it here. And I'm going to make sure to actually put the full print. And so that would actually tell me the length of that read. And I'll use that as a guideline. So it says it's 101. So I'm going to assume there's a new line there. And so it's really 100 nucleotide reads. So what I want to do is I'm going to define a list of, say, FRED scores. So I'm going to call it S sub I. So in other words, this is going to be a list that's going to define the different FRED scores as a function of position. And the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to define it as initially a list of zeros. And what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go here times 100. And then I'm also going to keep track of N, which is going to be like the total number of sequences. So maybe I would just call this N tote. This is going to be basically keep track of how many reads I've encountered at a given position I. So maybe I want to do this N sub I. Maybe that would be even more clear. To say that this is actually the position dependent, in other words, the position along the read I for each of these reads. And I'm going to loop through all the reads and I'm going to calculate the average FRED score. So I've got this, I've got my record, and now I want to be able to extract those FRED scores. Now the way you do that is a little bit, it's a little bit not obvious, but what it is it is, it's essentially an attribute of each record has a quality score. And what it is the following. I would do record dot letter annotations, and then in parentheses put FRED quality. Now what this will do is it'll actually give me the FRED scores themselves. So if you saw my video last time, you saw that the FRED scores were defined as minus 10 times the log of the probability of an error. Or it's defined, it's encoded in the ASCII characters. So for any character Q, you can use this ORD function to map it to a number, the number in the ASCII table. And because the first printable character, bang, or exclamation point, is 33, you subtract 33 to sort of reset it back to zero. And so if we wanted to, if we had access to those characters in the quality score string, we could parse it this way and get our FRED scores out. But the BioPython module does that for us. So once we have this array, so this is essentially a list. And so what I would like to do is, maybe what I'll do is I'll just call this qualities, quality, I don't know. Just call it quality. And this is should be a list. And what I should be able to do is loop through that and assign it to this cumulative sum of my scores and the total number of positions that I visited. And so what I might do is I might say for I in len, or actually not len, but range of len of quality. And so that would essentially loop through the indexes or indices of the quality score list. And then what I would do is I would say S sub I of I, basically position I, in that I want to add to my cumulative sum the quality score. And perhaps I should do something here. I'm going to print the quality and then break so that you can see what it looks like. So let's see how that works. Okay, so we can see that it is indeed a list of ints, and those ints define the quality scores. Just by looking at this example right here, we can see that at the beginning of the string, the numbers are somewhat larger. They actually dip down a little bit right here, and they also kind of get a little bit smaller towards the end of the sequence. And I think that we'll see that pattern continue throughout the FASTQ file. But what I want to do is I want to now update my count. So this is the number of reads that I visited at this position. And in this case, I just want to increment it by one because I'm just keeping a running total for each position I in my sequence. And so now at this point, after I've looped through all of my records, I have the sum of the quality scores as a function of the position I in the sequence, and I have the total number of quality scores that I visited as a function of I of the position across the sequence. So what I would want to do is I want to define the average FRED score. So maybe I would call that S average And another, you know, maybe what I want to do is I just want to say something like this. I want to say for I range of len. And I might just start off with the n sub I term. And then as an added check, I want to make sure that I at least have one read that I visited. So maybe what I might want to do is do something like if n sub I of I is strictly greater than 0. And then I want to define my S average. And that's going to be the S sub I of I divided by n sub I of I. And since I'm using Python 3, that should be able to just convert directly to a floating point. And maybe what I want to do is I want to plot something. So if I'm going to plot something, what I need to do is define some x values or x vals as a list, and then I'll define my y vals as a list for plotting. And my x vals are going to be the positions I, if I'm going to try to plot this, and then the y vals are going to be the s average. So now with this for loop, I was able to loop through the different positions of the reads and calculate an average Fred score and append it to a list. And so now I should be able to plot that. And in order to plot, I need to use, I'll just use a matplotlib, and I'll just assume that I've got something here, plot.plot, x vals and then y vals. And so that should get something started. And so maybe I might also do plot.x label and then give it a label. And this is the position, and I'll just put base pairs as my units. And then the plot dot y vals, y label actually, as the average quality score. Okay, so now I might do plot dot save fig, and then give it a name, and I'll just call it average quality or something like that. Okay, so now at this point I've basically save this, but I have to import some modules. So what I might do is the following. I would say I have to do something weird. So I have to import matplotlib, and I have to do this other weird thing. Import matplotlib as MPL, and I have to do MPL.use AGG. And so what this does, this essentially is a workaround that allows me to save a figure to a file. And then I have to do this. I have to do import matplotlib.pyplot as PLT. And that should import the PLT module that I just used here. And I'm just basically using matplotlib.pyplot and just giving it a shorthand name, just PLT for simplicity. And that's what this import statement will do. And that should allow me to save this file. Now let's see if this works. There may be an error, we'll find out. Python process, and it gives me an error. There's no module named matplotlib. Well, that's going to be a problem. Maybe what I can do is I can run this in Python 2. Let me see. Do I have Python 2? I have Python 2. So I think I can run this in Python 2, although that may complicate some other stuff. See what happens. Okay, so that seemed to work. And then reads.fastq. Okay, so I printed that out, and let's see if it actually saved a file. Okay, that didn't... I just got back. I checked the file. It didn't do anything. So what I want to do is I want to go back to Emacs and, well, oh, I got it. That's the break. I have a break here. So this didn't work because I have a break here. So I have to remove that, and I'll remove that print statement. I assume this will work. Now I'll try it again using Python 2 again, and I've got an error. So I've got the index is out of range, and that shouldn't be possible, but maybe it is. So what's going on here? So maybe what I'm gonna do is make this 101 to make sure it's just in case. I don't think that should be a problem, but. Okay, so that seemed to work, and it created a file. So there you have it, the average Fred score. I was able to plot this, and as you can see, the Fred score starts off a little bit lower, but still in a pretty good quality score range, goes up and then dips back down at some point around position 100. Now, this is going to vary, and the larger the FASTQ file you have, the better representation of this, but For this data, this is actually pretty good, and I hope this was informative and gave you some ideas on how you might go about plotting data and how you might go about processing FASTQ files. Maybe you might use this information to write a quality trimmer yourself. And with that, I will see you next time.